line there. It's time for literacy. It's time for literacy. Hey, where are we going? It's time for literacy. It's time for literacy. It's time for literacy. Hey, where are we going? It's time for literacy. Okay, hope you're fine wherever you are seated. Now, last time we looked at domestic animals. Domestic animals. Who can remind us what domestic animals are? Domestic animals are animals kept at home. The animals that we keep in our homes. Can you tell me examples of such animals that we keep in our homes? Yes, a pig, donkey, camel. Oh, wonderful. A rabbit. Thank you so much. Goats. Oh, okay. And so many others. From there, we also looked at the domestic animals which give us milk. We said which domestic animals give us milk? The goats and the buscat. She's saying, and the cows. Wonderful. What about the domestic animals that guard, the domestic animal that guards our home? When you are a visitor and you dare to go in someone's home, when it doesn't know you, it will boo, boo, boo. Which animal is that? Oh, it's a goat. Okay, thank you so much. Now, then we are continuing from where we stopped last time. We are going to look at the domestic animals that we use for transport. I told you last time, for me, if I don't have transport, my neighbor has all those animals that we mentioned. When I don't have money to pay the taxi, I don't have money to give to the boda-boda cyclists, the boda-boda men. What do? I just go to my neighbor. He gives me his camel. I sit comfortably and it brings me here at school. I think I've ever seen me coming at school using a camel or a donkey. So we have the domestic animals. Domestic animals that we use for transport. One is the donkey. Thank you so much. Have the donkey. The donkey. Or the donkeys. If there are many, you can call them donkeys. Yes. Any other? How many of you have ever seen someone seated on a donkey? Hey, where did you see? At the zoo. Okay. We have another domestic animal as the camel. The camel, if it's one, when there are many, we call them camels. This one also provides the transport. Then we have the horse. This one, the horse, or the horses, if there are many. We use these three animals for transport. We use them for transport. The donkey, the camel, and the horses. Is that okay? Now, we have domestic animals. We use it as pets. Domestic animals we use as pets. This one means that these animals, we like them. We like to stay with them at home. We sometimes we have the domestic animals that we use as pets. We use as pets are animals that people like to play with. They are animals that people like to play with. So pets are animals that we like to play with. animals. For example, the animals we keep as pets at home, we have, which animals do you play with in your home? Oh, we have a puppy. Thank you so much. We have a puppy. This one is a young dog. She's talking about a puppy or a dog. Let us say a dog or a puppy. A dog or a puppy, because a puppy is a young dog. Is that okay? Somebody is talking about cats. Thank you so much. Yes, some people keep cats to play with. Is that okay? They keep cats to play with. Any other? Even some people keep rabbits to play with. So domestic animals we use as pets. I told you pets, these are animals that we love to play with. We play with these animals. We can play with a dog. We can play with a cat. We can play with a puppy. A puppy is a young dog. And we can play with a cat or cats. And we can as well play with the kittens. We can as well play with kittens. But let me rub these ones and I remain with these ones. Examples of pet animals we keep at home for playing with, we have the dogs and the cats. Even some people keep rabbits as pets. Is that okay? Some people keep rabbits as pets. Rabbits as pets. They play with all those animals. Stand up, everybody. Once upon a time, someone is dozing. I'm not telling my story. Are you interested? Okay, everybody stand up. Stand up. Okay, sit down. Up, down. Now, you're going to look at a different thing, but connected to what we are learning now. I remember one day when I was still young, I grew up with my mother. And in our home, we had so many domestic animals. We had the pigs, we had the goats, we had the cows, we had the rabbits, we had the dogs. Time came, I remember I was in P1. Way back at our school, my teacher told me we were going for an educational tour. So when I went back home, I told my mother, "Mommy, they have said we are going for an educational tour, but the teacher said that we need to pay some money in order for us to go to that tour." My mother said, "I don't have that money." "Mommy, I don't want to miss out this tour. I also want to go for a tour with my friends." My mother said, "I don't have any money. You're going to stay home that day." I sat there while I knelt there in front of my mom. Then from there, my mother said, "But you know what should we do?" I was about to cry. My mom asked me. My face was so gloomy. Then my mother asked me, "Why are you annoyed with me?" Said, I want money to go and I enjoy with my friends at that tour." So my mother said, "Now what should we do? We had so many animals that, as I have told you." My mother decided to go and my mother sent me to go and I called a neighbor. Our neighbor had wanted so much to buy a goat from our home. So my mother sent me, I went, I called the neighbor came. When the neighbor came, mommy said, "You know, neighbor, I have my goat here. I want to sell it off because my daughter doesn't want to miss the educational tour that their school has organized. So, neighbor, help me. You give me money. I am selling my goat. Are you going to give me money?" My neighbor was so happy because he had already loved it. He had loved it. to buy these goats, but my mom would not allow. But because there was a problem, there was a challenge, we did not have the money to pay for a tour, my mom decided to sell off the goat. So the neighbor came, gave us money, then the neighbor took the goat to his home. My mom from there gave me the money. The next day I took the money for tour to my teacher. I was so excited. I tell you, I love my mother so much. Why? She gave me money to go for an educational tour. That is the end of my story. Now we are going to look at uses of domestic animals. Uses of domestic animals. Uses of domestic animals. Uses. When one talks about the word uses, what comes to your mind? How are they helpful? How are the domestic animals helpful to us? What do we get from them? What do we get from the domestic animals? Uses of the domestic animals. What do we get from the domestic animal? The first use is that, let me begin with mine. Because I still remember that scenario. My mom sold a goat and she gave me money for the tour. The first use, the first thing that I can remember, I can never forget in my life is that we sell them and get, we sell them and get money. My mom sold a goat. We got money and I went for a tour with my friends. Ha! I love my mother so much. Do you love yours? Okay. I know. We sell them and get money. What do we sell? The domestic animals. You can decide to sell your cow, your pig, your sheep, your rabbit, your dog, your cat. You get some. What else do we get from the domestic animals? Okay, we get milk. We get milk from those, from some. Actually, let's say not all. So we shall say some give us milk. Some, because we don't get milk from the postcard. So we shall say some give us milk. Some domestic animals give us milk. For example, we have already looked at animals which give us milk. We said they have goats and wonderful, just said cows. Any other? What else do we get from them? She said we get meat from them. You want to tell me that even you get meat, we get meat from the postcard? Now, we get meat from some, not all of them. So we shall say, some give us meat. And people enjoy, I know. I talked about domestic animals which give us meat and we shall look at that. Time to come, we get meat from some domestic animals and we eat and we enjoy and others salivate. Those who don't get a chance to eat, you just see them salivating. So we get meat from some domestic animals. For example, we get meat from the cows, from the goats, from the goats, from the rabbits, okay? Mm-hmm. Some give us meat. For it, let me put there animals which give us meat, like cows, like goats, like pigs, but for the Muslims, not eat these But for us, we Christians, we love it so much.
Like rabbits, we have a sheep,
excuse me,
and many others, and many others. So, some give us meat, like, now here we are talking about animals, the domestic animals, which give us meat and we eat. Cows, goats, pigs, rabbits, and sheep. Is that okay with you? Thank you so much. Any other use? This was the first one, the second one, the third one. What else did we get from them? Any other use of the domestic animals? Someone is saying we get... She wanted to tell me that... No, you need your friend to talk. She's saying we get cow dung. Ha! For me, I am a farmer. In my home, I even go and I buy the cow dung from my neighbors. And I put in my garden. So, the manure, the cow dung that I collect, the droppings, those ones, oh, they are very good in the garden. So we shall say, we get manure. We get manure. We get manure. The cow dung, the urine of the animals, the droppings, those ones work very well in our gardens. And you see me having a big bunch of matoke because I took my cow dung, I took the manure, and then I put in my garden. The manure it is the cow dung, the animal's urine, it is the manure that I talk about. So when the cow defecates, that cow dung is so good in the garden. When the pigs does so, when the rabbits, the goats, the sheep, that one is so good in the garden. It acts as manure. And at the end of that day, I will come back from the garden with a big bunch of matoke. Have you ever seen a bunch of matoke? From the bucket? I know. That is the bad thing for you. You are from Kampala. You are born from Kampala. You don't have a village. You have never gone to the village. Oh, mama. For us who... But at school, when you get a chance of coming back at school, just tell me, I'll take you to our banana plantation there. The one that sister planted. There are so many patches of matoke. And I'm telling you, we are enjoying it too much. So, we get the manure from those domestic animals. Then another one is that a dog guards our home. That is a very big use. A dog guards our home. When you're a stranger, you come into my home, it will bark at you. Hey, so it guards our home. Then we also have another use of the domestic animal is that Sam. We love to play with some domestic animals. So we shall say some animals are used as pets. Some animals are used as pets. I told you pets, these are the animals that we play with at home. We have already mentioned them, for example, give me examples of pet animals. A dog, a cat, ha ha, thank you so much. Now those ones are used as pets. Is there any other that I've left out? I don't think so. And then, have I talked about transport? Oh, I missed it out. Some animals are using it for transport. For example, I've already told you those animals for transport. If I don't have money to board a taxi, to get a border B, what do I use? I go to my neighbor, He gives me, he's a donkey. I comfortably sit on it and it brings me to school. So the animals that we use for transport are camels, donkeys, and horses. So these ones, I think we looked at them. Let's begin from here. Uses of domestic animals. What do we use these animals for? What do we get from them? The first use is that we sell them and get money. Even some of your parents, maybe they have never told you, the money that you pay here as school fees, your parents sell off some of these animals. Your mother can decide to sell off her cow and then she gets money and she brings you here at school. Some give us milk. I said not all, that's why I use the word some. We only get milk from two domestic animals, that's a goat and a cow. And we have already looked at that. The next one is that some give us meat. Like which domestic animals give us meat? We have the cows. Ha! I love it. The goats. Good meat. Pigs. We shall get pork. The rabbits. The pig, the meat from the rabbit pie is so nice. The sheep. They give us the mutton. Their meat. The meat we get from this domestic animal is so nice and delicious. So the next one is that we get manure. We get manure from those domestic animals. With the manure, I say the dung. The dung plus the urine of those animals or the droppings. That one is the one that I call manure. When you put in the garden, you will get good bunches of matoke, good mangoes, good oranges, good pineapples. Then the next one is that a dog guards our home. It is not like a dog that guards our home. Nor any other domestic animal that guards our home apart from the dog. Then we have said the sixth one is that some animals are used as pets. Pets, we play with them. We love to play with such animals. They are called pets. For example, we have already looked at them. We have the dogs, the cats, others. Take also rabbits to be their pets. And finally, I've said that some animals are used for transport, like the donkeys, the camels, and the horses. So those are some of the domestic, those are some of the uses of the domestic animals. Is that okay, girls? Thank you so much for listening. Hope you're tired, not so? Mukoye, ndate tunava kukowa, mukoye. Oh, someone is saying she is tired. Okay, we shall begin from there next time. Bye bye, I love you.